ओमज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपकदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं। वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरो श्रीयुतापदकमलं श्रीगुरून्वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातां सहगणारघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनासहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपदान् सहगणाललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च। नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नामिने। नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। हरे कृष्णा। थैंक यू वेरी मच डियर डिवोटीज फॉर काइंड एसोसिएशन। वेलकम बैक मुक्त संग प्रभु फ्रॉम योर इंडियन यात्रा एंड दंडवत प्रणाम डियर प्रद्युम्न प्रभु। हरे कृष्णा। विथ योर ब्लेसिंग्स विल गेट स्टार्टेड। सो वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग अवर रीडिंग ऑफ श्री चैतन्य भागवत बाय श्रील वृंदावन दास ठाकुर एंड वी आर रीडिंग फ्रॉम द आदि खंड चैप्टर नंबर 9। लास्ट टाइम वी रेड अंटिल वर्स नंबर 104 आई थिंक। So we'll continue from verse number 105. So Mukta Sangha, I just want to make you the co-host. Okay, we'll get started. Hare Krishna. So we'll start from verse number 105. Shri Vrindavan Das Thakur is going to describe something very sweet and very wonderful now, my dear friends. So please pay attention. We saw how Shri Nityananda Prabhu appeared in Eka Chakra Dham as the son of Hadai Pandit and Srimati Padmavati Devi, and how he was the darling of the entire village of Eka Chakra. How he engaged all the children in wonderful Krishna conscious dramas. Every day they would do different dramas. And when he was 12 years old, a visiting sannyasi came and Sri Nityananda Prabhu Nitai left with that sannyasi and never came back to Eka Chakra. It's a very painful story, and Srila Vrindavan Das Thakur doesn't have the heart to describe it, but it is described in Bhakti Ratnakar by Sri Narahari Chakravarti. But anyway, it's a very painful story. So Srila Vrindavan Das Thakur, being a lover of Sri Nityananda Prabhu, he skips all that. He just describes the travels of Sri Nityananda Prabhu. So verse number 105 of the 9th chapter of Adi Khanda. Shuna Sri Chaitanya Priya Tamera Khatana Yemate Karila Tirtha Mandali Brahmana. Please listen, Srila Vrindavan Das Thakur is saying. Please listen, Sri Chaitanya Priyatamera Kathana. Whose story? The one who is very dear to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He doesn't say Nityananda Prabhu. It is implied. So please hear Sri Chaitanya Priyatamera Kathana. The one who is most dear to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, hear his story. And who is that Gaura Priyajan? It is Sri Nityananda Prabhu. Yemate Karila Tirtha Mandali Brahmana. Please listen how Nitai performed Brahmana, traveled to various places of pilgrimage. Text number 106. Prathame chalila prabhu tirtha vakreshwara tabe vaidyanath vane gela ekeshwara. So our Nityananda Prabhu went to Vakreshwar, and from there he went to Vaidyanath, and he's called Ekeshwar because he went alone. He didn't have anyone. He went alone. After spending some time with the sannyasi, our Nitai traveled by himself. Gaya giya kashi gela Shiva Rajadhani Yahi Dhara Vahe Ganga Uttara Vahini. Nitai went to Gaya. And then he went to Lord Shiva's abode, Kashi, where the Ganga flows towards the north. Ganga dekhi bada sukhi Nityananda rae snana kare pana kare aarti nahi jaye. Seeing Ganga, Lord Nityananda was very pleased. He took his bath, he drank water of Ganga, snana kare pana kare aarti nahi jaye. But still, Nitai's grief was not mitigated even after taking bath and drinking Ganga water. Why? Because our Nitai is feeling separation from Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Where is my Gauranga Mahaprabhu? When will he appear? When will he come in this world? Prayage karila magh mase prathasnan tabe mathuraye gela purva janmasthan. In the month of Magh, very cold, January, February, Lord Nityananda Prabhu took early morning bath at Prayag, the place of confluence of Ganga and Yamuna. Our Srila Prabhupada also, when he went for the Ardha Kumbh Mela, he set a very glorious example. Even at his advanced age of almost 75, 76 years old, Srila Prabhupada, he did not hesitate to take a cold bath in the confluence of Ganga and Yamuna. As an Acharya, he's teaching us. Tabe mathuraye gela purva janmasthan. And after Prayag, where did Nitai go? He went to Mathura, which is Purva Janmasthan, his birthplace in his previous avatar. Verse number 110. Yamuna Vishrama Ghate Kari Jalakeli Govardhana Paravate Bulena Kutuhali. So Nitai went to Yamuna. He went to Vishram Ghat. And Kari Jalakeli. What did Nitai do at in Yamuna and at Vishram Ghat? He entered the waters and he sported there with the boys of Vrindavan, the Vrajavasi boys. Nitai played with them. Govardhana Paravate Bulena Kutuhali. And then with great interest, he went to see Govardhan. Shri Vrindavana Adiyata Dvadasha Vana Eke Eke Prabhu Sabha Karena Brahmana. There are Dvadasha Kanana, there are 12 forests in Vrindavan. Vrindavana Ramya Sthana Divya Chintamani Dhamma. In our Chintamani Dham, Shri Vrindavan Dham, there are 12 forests, Dvadasha Kanana. And Nitai visited each and every forest of Vrindavan. Gokule Nandera Ghara Vasati Dekhiya Vistara Rodana Prabhu Karila Vasiya. Then he went to Gokul, where there is the old home of Nanda Baba, where Krishna and Balram lived for Krishna's first 3.5 years of his Leela. So after going there, Nitai is remembering his time, his pastimes in Gokul. How Krishna had killed Putana, how Krishna had killed Trinavarta, Shakatasur, how Krishna did the Mrit Bhakshan Leela, how Krishna ate the mud, how Krishna ate Vrajaraja, and Nitai had complained to Yashoda Maiya. All those pastimes, Krishna showing the universal, the entire universe in his lotus mouth to Mother Yashoda. And then Mother Yashoda binding Krishna to the ulukhal, to the wooden grinding mortar, and with a stick, all the Damodar Leela, it took place. And how Balramji had gone and seen his little Kanha tied to a mortar like a prisoner, and how angry Nitai is remembering, how angry I had become as Balram. Who has tied my Kanha?
Who dare ties my Krishna, my little younger brother? Because Balram is very protective about Kanha. And he's asking everybody, who tied, who tied, who tied? And when the friends of Krishna said, Yashoda Maiya, Balram got scared. And then he saw Krishna. Krishna had high hopes that my elder brother Balramji will save me, will rescue me from having been tied. So then when Krishna saw that even Balramji is helpless when it comes to Mother Yashoda, then Krishna started crying, started crying even more. Now no one can help me. Even Dauji cannot help me. When Krishna started crying like that, again Balramji got angry. Seeing Krishna's tears, who dares bind my brother, my little brother Krishna? Who did this? Who did this? And just then Mother Yashoda came. And Balramji, in his loving anger, his anger caused by his intense love for Kanha, he tells Mother Yashoda, Maiya, why did you bind Krishna? This is such a harsh punishment. How can you treat my brother like this? How can you treat Krishna like this? How can you just tie him like an animal with ropes? You have used the ropes used to tie cows. You have tied my brother to the wooden grinding mortar. Where will he go? What will he do? Don't you know who my brother is? Do you think my brother is just some ordinary boy? In his previous appearance in this world, he was Lord Ramachandra, in whose glorification the original poem Adi Kavi Valmiki Muni wrote. Valmiki Muni in 24,000 Anushtup verses was glorifying this brother of mine. He's Ram. He's Parshuram. He's Vaman. He's Matsyadev. He's Kurmadev. Mother Yashoda raises her stick and says, Acha, and who are you? I am Lakshman. When he was Ram, I was Lakshman. He is Mahavishnu. And when he lies down on the ocean, I become Anantashesh. I am Ananta. I am Lakshman. I am this. I am that. Mother Yashoda said, all right. All the avatars have to take birth in my home only. Come, let me give you good. And when Balram just saw the stick of Mother Yashoda, he jumped and ran away. So Nitai is remembering all these pastimes in Gokul. And he's crying tears of love and separation from Nimai. Gokule nandera ghara vasati dekhiya vistara rodana prabhu karila vasiya. He sat down and cried in Nanda Bhavan, in Gokul. Tabe prabhu madana gopala namaskari chalila hastinapura pandavera puri. Then Nityananda Prabhu went to take darshan of Madana Gopal and offered his obeisances to Madan Gopal. This Madan Gopal deity was previously found by Advaita Acharya. Advaita Acharya is 52 years elder to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Sri Haridas Thakur is 35 years elder to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Krishna, how old is, by how many years is Nitai elder to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Wait, let me, where are you? Okay. You can unmute Krishna. What is the age difference between Nitai and Nimai? Who is elder? Nityananda Prabhu is elder?
Nityananda Prabhu is elder.
By how many years? Look, Amarendra Prabhu is helping you. Look at the chat box. Yeah, 12 to 13 years. So Kirtida Sundari Matari said 12. Amarendra Prabhu said 13. And both are right. 12 to 13 years. It cannot be exact. So 12 to 13 years. So this is... So our Nita is remembering all this. So Nityananda Tabe Prabhu Madana Gopala Kari Namaskari Chalila Hastinapura Pandavera Puri. So this Madana Gopal, previously Advaita Acharya, when Advaita Acharya was a brahmachari many, many years ago, when Advaita Acharya, so Krishna if Advaita Acharya is 52 years elder to Nimai and Nitai is 12 years elder, what is the age difference between Advaita Acharya and Nityananda Prabhu? This is advanced math. Look, Mataji is helping you.
Mataji is helping
40 years difference. So much before, many years before Advaita Acharya, when he was a Brahmachari, before Advaita Acharya got married to Srimati Sita Thakurani, he had gone to Vrindavan in his Brahmachari days. And at that time, Advaita Acharya had discovered the deity of Madan Gopal, which was originally installed by Vajranam. Vajrana was the great-grandson of Lord Krishna. So this deity was found by Advaita Acharya. Sri Advaita Acharya worshipped Madan Gopal in Vrindavan for a long time. And then when he had to come back to Navadvip, knowing that in the future, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is going to appear and I have other duties to perform there, I have to cry to invite Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he went back to Navadvip. But before he went to Navadvip, he gave the worship of Madan Gopal. So therefore, to other devotees. So therefore, when Nityananda Prabhu went to Vrindavan, Madan Gopal was already being worshipped. And therefore, it is said, Tabe Prabhu Madana Gopala Namaskari Chalila Hastina Pura Pandavera Puri. After taking darshan and offering obeisances to Madan Gopal, our Nitai went to Hastinapur. Bhaktasthana Dekhi Prabhu Karena Krandana Nabhuje Tairthika Bhakti Shunmera Karana. Now, in Hastinapur, which is present day Delhi, people were not devotees. Most of them were not devotees. Therefore, it is said that Tairthika Bhakti Shunne, the residents of that Tirthasthan, Hastinapur, which is a holy place, the residents had degraded into becoming Bhakti Shunya, non-devotees. So, but it is a place of Bhaktas, it is a place of the Pandavas. So, Bhaktasthana Dekhi Prabhu Karena Krandana. Nitai cried in separation from the Pandavas and also because Nabhuje Tairthika Bhakti Shunyara Karana. Because the local people could not understand the bhav of Nitai. Why? Because they were Bhakti Shunya. They were devoid of devotion. This is the effect of Kali Yuga. Even in holy places, sometimes we see that people are not devoted. Balrama Kirti Dekhi Hastina Nagare Trahi Haladhara Bali Namaskar Kare. Our Nitai, he remembered the glorious activities of Lord Balaram in Hastinapur. What was that glorious activity? When Balaramji saw that the Kauravas headed by Duryodhan and Dushasan and Shakuni and Karna, they are not respecting our Krishna, Dwarkadhish Krishna. And they are not respecting the son of Krishna, Sam, who had wanted to marry the daughter of Duryodhan, Lakshmana. And they had, 6 Maharathis had attacked Sam, overpowered him and jailed him, put him in jail, captured him. When Balramji went to negotiate peace, Balramji's student, Duryodhan, he offered respect to Balram, but he disrespected Krishna. He disrespected Krishna and Krishna's son, Sam. Balramji did not accept the worship of Duryodhan. And he got so angry when Duryodhan spoke insulting words for the Yadavas that with the tip of his axe, Haladhar Balramji, the tip of his axe, Balramji, first of all, he looked at Ganga, and in obedience to Balram, Ganga Mata, Ganga Devi, she swelled up with water. She became huge. Her water was surging and overflooding. And then with the tip of his plow, our Haldhar Balramji, he started dragging the whole, he uprooted the entire city of Hastinapur and started dragging it towards the huge Ganga. Ganga had become huge like ocean. It was going to swallow Hastinapur. And even great Maharathis, Atirathis like Bhishma Dev, they fell, they lost their balance and got scared. What is Bhishma's bow and arrow going to do against Balram? any Maharathi, whether it is Dronacharya or Karna, they are insignificant particles of dust in front of our Nitai, Nityananda Ram, Balram. They all got scared and they all came. Bhishma Dev came trembling and falling at the feet of our Balramji. And our Nitai is remembering this. Balaram Kirti, the glorious activities of Balramji. Balaram Kirti Dekhi Hastina Nagare Trahi Haladhara Bali Namaskara Kare. He remembered the prayers of Duryodhana. Trahi, Trahi, please save us, Balramji. We made a mistake. Sorry, sorry. Forgive us, forgive us. We will give a lot of dowry and we will return Sam and Lakshmana to Dwarka. Let them get married. Our full support is there. They got scared. Tabe Dwarka ai lena Nityananda Samudre Karila Snana Haila Ananda. After Hastinapur, my dear friends, our beloved Nitai, our Prananath Nitai, he went to Dwarka. And there, with great happiness, he took his bath in the holy water of the ocean. Siddhapura gela yatha kapile rasthan matsyatirthe mahotsave karila annadan. Our Nitai, he went to a place called Siddhapur, which is a holy place where Lord Kapila Dev does his bhajan. Very holy place. Lord Kapila Dev is Bhagwan. He's an incarnation of Krishna, the son of Srimati Devahuti Muni and Shri Kardama Muni. He went there. Nitai went there. Then Nitai went to Matsya Tirtha, where Karila Annadan. Annadan. Food for life. Our Nitai is the original. He is doing food for life. He is distributing prasadam to the holy people who live there. Shiva Kanchi, Vishnu Kanchi, Gela Nityananda. Dekhi hase dui gane maha maha dvandva. Our beloved Nitai went to Shiv Kanchi and Vishnu Kanchi. Shiv Kanchi is the place where the devotees of Lord Shiva, the greatest Vaishnav, reside. And Vishnu Kanchi is the place where the Vaishnavas reside. And from time immemorial, there is always dvandva, always quarrel and fighting between these two groups. The Shaivites, they claim that Lord Shiva is the supreme. And Lord Vishnu is a devotee of Lord Shiva. And of course, we Vaishnavas, we know that Vaishnavanam Yatha Shambhu. Lord Shiva, he is a Vaishnav. And he's a very special tattva as mentioned in Brahma Samhita. Just like Kshiram Yatha Dadivikara Yoga. Just like Kshiram milk, it transforms Vikar into dadhi, into yogurt, by the action of tamarind or sour substance, milk transforms into dahi, into curd. Similarly, Lord Shiva is a transformation of Lord Vishnu. He is a special form of Lord Vishnu. He is a guna avatar of Lord Vishnu, Shiva Tattva. Shiram Yatha Dadhi Vikara Vishesha Yoga. Yes, our Amarendra who is sharing this beautiful verse from Brahma Samhita. Kshiram Yatha Dadhi Vikara Vishesha Yoga Sanjayate Nahitatha Pritagasti Heto Yaha Shambhutam Apitatha Samupaeti Karyat Govindamadi Purusham Tamaham Bhajami. So we know this. Just as milk is transformed into curd, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada has given translation, just as milk is transformed into curd by the action of acids. But yet the effect curd is neither same nor different from its cause, which is milk. So I adore the primal Lord Govinda, of whom the state of Shambhu, Shiva Tattva, is a transformation for the performance of the work of destruction. Guna Avatar, Tamugun, Adhikari, Lord Shiva. So yogurt or curd and milk, they have the same calcium content. What is the calcium content of milk and yogurt? Same. What is the protein content? Same. What is the fat content? Same. There is no difference. What is the color? Same. Milk and yogurt, same color, same calcium, same glucose content, same calories, same protein. Everything is same. But the effect is different. You cannot make paneer from yogurt. You cannot. You need milk to make paneer. And from yogurt, you cannot get milk. From dahi, you cannot get milk. But from milk, you can get dahi. So who is Sarvakarana Karanam? It is Govinda. It is Krishna. Not Lord Shambhu. So we know this. We know that Lord Shiva is a very special manifestation of Krishna. But he is in the mood of a Vaishnava. In the mood of a Vaishnava. Therefore, Shivji is called Vaishnava. Vaishnavanam yatha Shambhu. And Lord Shivji's eternal consort, Srimati Parvati Devi, is called Vaishnavi. Vaishnava Devi. She is Vaishnavi. And Lord Shiva is Vaishnava. But there is always this fighting. And who is Nityananda Prabhu? He is the source of Lord Shiva. He is the source of Vishnu. So here are devotees of Vishnu and devotees of Shivaji fighting. And here is Nitai, the source of Mahavishnu and the source of Shivaji. So Nitai is the first expansion of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He is Balram. Brajendra Nandana Jai Shashi Suta Hoilo Se Balram Hoilo Nitai. So from Nityananda Prabhu comes Mahavishnu. From Nityananda Prabhu comes Mahavishnu. And from Vishnu comes Shambhu, Lord Shiva. So here is a source of Mahavishnu and source of Lord Shambhu. And what does he do? Dekhi hase dui gane maha mahadvandu. Seeing their fight, our Nityananda Prabhu, he simply laughed. Hase. Oh, what these foolish people. And leaving bhajan aside, they are quarreling. This is the age of quarrel. Kalahalati iti kali. These are Kali Yuga people. Why are they fighting? This is not good. Kurukshetre prithudake bindu sarovare prabhase gelena sudar shana tirthabhare. Then Nityananda Prabhu visited holy places like Kurukshetra, prithudaka, bindu sarovar, prabhas kshetra, sudarshana tirtha. Tritakupa mahatirtha gelena vishala. Tabe brahma tirtha chakra tirthera chalila. He also visited holy place like Tritakup. He also visited Vishala. He visited Brahma tirtha and Chakra tirtha. Pratishrota gela yatha prachi saraswati naimisha aranya tabe gela mahamati. Our most magnanimous Mahamati Nityananda Prabhu, he visited Pratishrota, where the Saraswati flows in the opposite direction. He then went to Naimisharanya. So here in the commentary, Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada writes, in Srimad Bhagavatam 11.30.6, it is clearly stated, Vayam Prabhasam Yasyamo Yatra Prityag Saraswati. We shall go to Prabhasa Kshetra, where the river Saraswati flows west. According to Srila Sridhar Swami's commentary, the word pratyag means flowing towards the west. And according to Bhagavat Chandrika of Sri Veera Raghava Acharya, we shall go to a place known as Prabhasa, where the Saraswati flows in the opposite direction and enters into the ocean. So everything that is there in Sri Chaitanya Bhagavat, it is corroborated, it is confirmed by authorized scriptures like Sri Mad Bhagavatam and various commentaries on Srimad Bhagavatam. So Nityananda Prabhu visited all these holy places like Naimisharanya, Saraswati River, Pratishrota. Tabe gela Nityananda Ayodhya Nagara Ramajan Mabhumi Dekhi Kandila Vistara. Our beloved Nitai, who is Lakshman, he then visited the city of Ayodhya, where he cried upon seeing the birthplace of Sri Ram. Ayodhya is a place of love and crying. And Nitai, only Nitai knows what Nitai was thinking in Ayodhya. He's Lakshman. So many pastimes have taken place in Ayodhya. The birth of Sri Ram, the childhood pastimes of Sri Ram, the painful banishment of Sri Ram for 14 years, for 12 years. 12 years, no? How many years Lord Ram went for one was? 14 years? 14. 14 years, huh? The Pandavas went for 12 plus 1. So 14 years. Thank you, Aparna Mataji. Thank you, Mukta Sangha Prabhu. 14 years vanvas, the banishment. And then Shri Ramchandra returned with Sita Devi. And there was Diwali celebration in Ayodhya. And for 11,000 years, Shri Ram, he ruled from Ayodhya and established the famous Ram Rajya. Our Raja Ram, Sita Ram, they established Ram Rajya in Ayodhya. But that's not all, my dear friends. Why is Nitai crying with so much overwhelming emotions? So many devotees, great, great devotees have performed bhajan in Ayodhya. So many great, great devotees have performed bhajan in Ayodhya. Our Nitai is remembering all that. These places like Janakpur and Ayodhya, they are very, very special places, my dear friends. Our acharyas explain that these places are so powerful. Please listen carefully. These places are so powerful that anyone from these holy places like Ayodhya and Janakpur, anyone, a person, everyone is very great. Everyone is dhamvasi. Even a person who is pulling a rickshaw or even a sweeper on the street can give divine knowledge, can give transcendental knowledge. So Nitai, when he visited Ayodhya, he is seeing all this. He is seeing his Ram. He is seeing Bharat's love for Ram, how he lived in Nandigram in separation. How when Lavanasur had to be killed, Shatrughna told Bharat, Bharat, this time you don't go. You don't experience any more separation from Ram. I will go and fight with Lavanasur. All these loving exchanges. And then through the ages, through generations, thousands of years, so many Ram Bhaktas have lived in Ayodhya and they have done their bhajan and they have cried. This is Pavan Bhumi, Ayodhya. Nitai is seeing all this in the mood of Lakshman and he's crying. Even apparently ordinary people are very, very great devotees, my dear friends, in these holy places. There was one Brahman couple staying in Janakpur. Janakpur is the birthplace of Srimati Janaki Rani, Srimati Sita Devi. And this Brahman couple was very simple and they had a lot of nishtha, a lot of faith in Vaishnav Seva. They didn't have so much money. They were simple Brahmins. But they did their japa, they did their study of the Shastra, and they followed their dharma nicely. And they served the Vaishnavas. Any Vaishnava who would come to Janakpur, they would serve them. And one day, a very great Vaishnav came to the house of this couple. And this couple, whatever they had, they cooked and they served this Vaishnav very nicely. When this Vaishnav sadhu was leaving their house, they offered obeisances and begged for blessings. They did not have any children, this Brahman couple. It had been many years since they were married and they did not have a child. So they offered their obeisances to this sadhu. Did not say anything, but the sadhu understood what is in their heart. He said, you are very nice devotees, both of you. And you are living in a very holy place, Janakpur. This is a very holy place, Mithila. Very nice. Here, Sita and Ram met each other for the first time in a garden. This is the place. This is the place where the marriage of Sita and Ram took place. This is the place where Lord Ramachandra broke the Shivdhanush. This is the place where Lord Ramachandra reduced the pride of Lord Parshuram. It's a very holy place. But a Mahakumbh Mela is about to take place in Prayag. Again, the place where Nitai just visited. You go to Prayag and there is a confluence of Ganga, Jamuna and Saraswati. And there at the Sangam of these three rivers, Triveni Sangam, you go and during the Mahakumbh Mela, thousands and thousands of sadhus come there. You go there, live there for a month during the Mahakumbh Mela. This story happened around 200 years ago, my dear friends. True story, around 200 years ago. It happened. Not a very old story. So this Brahman couple went on the instructions of this sadhu. For 1 month, they stayed in the Mahakumbh Mela at Triveni Sangam. And many sadhus came and they enthusiastically served. Any sadhu they would find, they would serve. Whatever service, they would cook, they would wash their clothes, and they would do some menial service for them, fill water and bring for them, help them hold their clothes well while they were taking a bath. Some menial service they performed for 1 month at the Triveni Sangam. After doing a lot of Vaishnava Seva, getting the blessings of many, many sadhus, many, many devotees, they came back to Mithila, they came back to Janakpur. And immediately after coming back, within a short while, the Brahmani, the wife, she was blessed with a child. She became pregnant. And they were very happy. And they knew that this is the mercy of the sadhus at Prayag. We went to Prayag, we did Vaishnava Seva, and this child is an answer to our prayers and to our Vaishnava Seva that we did at Prayag. So even before the child was born, the parents decided that when this child is born, if he's a son, we will name him Prayag Datta. Child who was given to us by the holy place, Prayag. Prayag Datta. And when the mother became pregnant, when the Brahmani became pregnant, unfortunately, her husband, the very wonderful Brahman Sadhu, Brahman Vaishnava, he fell ill. As the pregnancy increased and the months went by, the husband became sicker and sicker and more ill. His health became weaker and weaker. And the day the Brahmani gave birth to Prayag Datta, that very day, the husband died. Prayag Datta's father died. And when this child, Prayag Datta, who was now being raised by the widow, the Brahmani, very great devotee, even though she lost her husband in such an untimely way, her faith in Sita and Ram did not reduce. She kept chanting, Sita Ram, Sita Ram, Sita Ram, Sita Ram, and tried her best with the meager means that she had to bring up Prayag Datta nicely. When Prayag Datta started crawling, when he was few months old and started crawling, the house caught on fire and everything was burnt and destroyed. Anyway, they didn't have much money, just a little house. And now that house is also destroyed completely. Look at the Leela of Bhagwan, how he tests his devotees. When he was conceived, the father became ill. As he was growing in his mother's womb, the father got more and more ill. The day Prayag Datta was born, his father died. And when Prayag Datta started crawling, the house caught on fire and they lost everything. They lost their house, they lost all their furniture, they lost everything that they had. And now this single widowed mother, poor lady, now she has got the responsibility of bringing up Prayag Datta, this son who is just few months old. But she had a faith that he is born as a result of our sincere prayers and sincere Vaishnava Seva. Therefore, there is no doubt that this little boy who is crawling, Prayag Datta, is a very, very great devotee. And I must serve him. I must bring him up in a very Krishna conscious way. So whatever she could beg, she would collect and she would try to serve the Vaishnavas. Whatever remained, she fed her son, Prayag Datta. And if anything remained, she ate. This was a simple life of this lady, great devotee. Her bhav was that, because she is from Janakpur, it is the birthplace of Srimati Janki Devi. This is Janakpur. So birthplace of Srimati Janki Devi, Srimati Sita Devi. So what was the bhav of this lady? That Sita is my daughter. This is the bhav. This is bhakti bhav. This is the sambandha that we need to have with Bhagavan. She was convinced, my daughter is Sita. And she continued with her devotion, continued her to try her best to bring up Prayag Datta. But Prayag Datta was considered to be inauspicious by everyone. All the friends, neighbors, they would shun him. अरे बाबा, when he was conceived, father got an incurable disease. As he grew in the womb, father got sicker and sicker. The day he was born, that same day father died. And after he was born, very soon the whole house caught on fire. Bap re bap. This boy is very evil and very unfortunate. Bad luck personified. We should not let our children play with him. So no one played with Prayag Datta. Poor Prayag Datta. Just a simple boy. He has no siblings. He has no father. He has no money. He has no house. He's living under a tree. Poor boy. Beggar. He has lost everything. His mother is chanting Sitaram, 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 Sitaram. And they have nothing. And no one wants to play with him. So Prayag Datta had no one to play, but he would simply sit and watch other boys and girls play. And seeing their play, he would feel satisfaction. And even while watching their game, he would be chanting, Sitaram Jaya Sitaram, Sitaram Jaya Sitaram, 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 Sitaram Jaya Sitaram. This was his only happiness, Prayag Datta. Always chanting the name of Sitaram, Sitaram. He learned it from his mother. Sitaram, 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 Sitaram. One day, it was the appearance day of our Nityananda Ram as Balram. What was it? It was Balram Purnima. And what is Balram Purnima? Our Nitai. What is Balram Purnima? It is also Raksha Bandhan. We tie Rakhi to Balramji on that day. So it was Raksha Bandhan. All the sisters, they tie Rakhi to their brothers. And our Prayag Datta, little boy, he is 8 years old. And he's sitting and he is watching his friends play. And some boys are playing. And suddenly, a didi comes, an elder sister comes. And she pats on the shoulder of one of the boys who is engrossed in play and says, my dear brother, come. Today is Raksha Bandhan. It's time for me to tie Rakhi to you. Come, come home. Immediately this boy gives up his play. He holds the hand of his didi, his elder sister, and goes home. It is Balram Jayanti. It is Raksha Bandhan. And Prayag Datta has never seen anything like this. He doesn't have any siblings. And he's seeing that this didi came and she's taking this boy to tie Rakhi. So he also walked behind them to see what is this Rakhi. He didn't know what Raksha Bandhan was. And through the window he saw. And this didi, she went home. She told the boy, go wash your feet, wash your hands, wash your mouth, come sit. So he came and sat on asan. And this didi came and the parents were there. And they celebrated Raksha Bandhan. What did the didi do? She came. She put nice tilak for her brother. She offered nice aarti to him with the ghee lamp and everything. And then she took a nice rakhi made of silk. And she tied it to the right hand, right wrist of her brother. And she took nice mithai, nice laddu, and fed the brother with her own hands. And Prayag Datta is watching through the window. Wow! This sister loves her younger brother so much. What a beautiful festival this is, Raksha Bandhan. I also want this. I also want to have Raksha Bandhan. And he turned around and he ran to his mother. And he said, mother, I want to celebrate Raksha Bandhan. I want to celebrate Raksha Bandhan. And mother said, my dear child, Raksha Bandhan is a festival between a brother and a sister. Yes, I also want my didi. I want my didi to come and feed me laddus and tie Rakhi to my hand. I want a sister. Do I have a sister, mother? And the poor widow, she was thinking, the only child I have is this Prayag Datta, and he's so unfortunate. No one plays with him. He doesn't have a father. We don't have any money. And now he wants to celebrate Raksha Bandhan. Raksha Bandhan, he needs a sister. But does he have a sister? And then immediately she remembered. Why not? I have a daughter. My daughter is Sita. So she is the didi of my son. She is Prayag Datta's elder sister. Mother said, yes, you have a sister. Prahlada's eyes became big. What? I have a sister. You never told me. What is her name? Where is she? Are, your sister is not like some sister of this world. She is not an ordinary sister. She is very beautiful. Very beautiful. And when she was just a Kumari, when she was just a young girl, your sister got married to Chakravarti Samrat, Shri Ram, who is the king of a very beautiful city called Ayodhya. Just like this is Janakpur, there is Ayodhya. And a very beautiful city. And the king is Shri Ram. And your sister Sita, she is married to Shri Ram. She is the queen of Ayodhya. Your sister is not some ordinary girl. Yes, you have a sister. Prayagdat started crying. He said, Maiya, I want to go to Ayodhya. I want to meet my sister. On Raksha Bandhan, I'm supposed to be with my sister. Why am I here? Why you are not sending me to Ayodhya? I also want her to do aarti to me. I want her to tie rakhi to me. I want her to feed me laddus with her own hands. I want to go to Ayodhya. I want to meet my sister. I want to meet my didi, Sita didi. Please take me. Please take me. Please take me. He started crying, started pulling at the sari of his mother. Mother said, Beta, I don't have any money. I don't have any means. How will we travel to Ayodhya? We don't even have money for a dinner. We don't know where the next meal will come from. How can we go to Ayodhya? It takes money and resources to travel. This is just 200 years ago, my dear friends. But the mother prayed. She prayed to Sitaram, please fulfill the desire of Prayagdatta. Please bless him. Soon, a group of pilgrims came to Janakpur. Janakpur being a holy place, all the time pilgrims are coming. So a pilgrim came, a group of pilgrims came, and they came, they took darshan of the beautiful place, Janakpur, and they were leaving. And they came to meet this mother, Prayagdatta's mother, and she bowed down, she offered them whatever little she had. And they said, we are on our way from Janakpur to Ayodhya. Please bless us, Maya, that our pilgrimage to Ayodhya is successful. Mother said, I will pray that your pilgrimage to Ayodhya is successful. But Prayagdatta is listening. He's saying, Maya, these sadhus are going from Janakpur to Ayodhya. Can I please go with them? Don't worry, I don't need any money to travel with these sadhus. They will take care of everything. They will take care of me. Please, please, please hand me over to them. Let me go on pilgrimage with them. They will take me to Ayodhya. Please, Maya, please don't say no. And the sadhu said, yes, we will take him. What could Maya say? She said, okay, you go. I will meet my sister. I will meet my sister. I will meet Sita Didi. I will go to Ayodhya. He started jumping Prayagdatta. And mother also went into such a devotional emotion. She said, yes, you go and meet Sita Didi, but you cannot go to the house of your sister empty handed. You must take something, some gift for her, but we don't have anything. Let me go and beg something. And what will you eat on the way? Let me go and beg something. So this poor mother, she goes knocking on people's doors and saying, my son is my 8-year-old son. He is going to Ayodhya. He's going to Ayodhya on a pilgrimage with sadhus. Please give me something for him to eat on the way. And please give me something so he can offer Sita and Ram in Ayodhya. Please, please. People thought he's going to offer the deities of Sita and Ram. Because in Ayodhya, there is a temple of Sita and Ram. They said, okay, okay, okay. They gave some broken pieces of chipped rice. Poha. Some pieces of poha to this lady. And they gave some laddus made of dry fruits for the boy to eat on the way. Some energy he will get. So they gave some little few laddus for the boy to eat for Prayagdatta, and they gave some poha to take for Sita, Didi. And she tore a piece of her own sari. She didn't even have a gift wrapping cloth or any paper. She took a piece of her own sari. She put that chipped rice poha in that, tied a knot and gave it to Prayagdatta and said, Beta, child, this is for Didi. When you meet her, you should never meet your Didi empty-handed. Always give her a gift. So this is a gift. Because on Raksha Bandhan, when Didi ties a rakhi, the brother is supposed to give the sister a gift. So you give this poha as gift to your sister. This will not get spoiled. And for you on the way, you will feel hungry, beta. So take these 2-3 laddus. They will last you. And go to meet Sita Didi. Go to meet your sister. And with the sadhus, immediately Pragdatta started jumping up and down, all excited. I'm going to meet my Didi. I'm going to meet Sita Didi. He could not control his enthusiasm. The sadhus could not keep up with him. Pragdatta ran ahead. In his enthusiasm, I will go to Ayodhya, I'm going to meet my Didi. My Didi will offer ghee lamp. My Didi will give me laddus. My Didi will tie rakhi on my hand. My Didi will give me so much love and affection. I am going to Ayodhya. Come on. He's telling the sadhus, come fast. You are walking too slow. I cannot contain myself. Started running ahead of them. And when they came on the outskirts of Ayodhya, he did not even wait for the sadhus. He just ran. He just ran. Didi, Didi, Didi. He was screaming, Didi, Didi, where are you? Where are you? Mother had told him. He had asked his mother, how will I find my Didi? She said, who doesn't know your sister in Ayodhya? She is the queen of Ayodhya. Just go and tell, my sister is Sita. And they will ask you, who is the husband? And you say, husband is Sri Ram. And everybody will know. Go. So he entered the city of Ayodhya. And he's asking everyone, where is my sister Sita Didi? Where is my sister Sita Didi? Sita Didi, who is the husband? Which family? She is the queen of Ayodhya. Her husband is Sri Ram. Oh, okay. They laugh. Okay. Now we understand. Okay, go there. You see that big mahal? You see that big palace? That is where Sita and Ram live. Go there. Are they there? Yes, they are always there only. They are talking about the deities. But our Prayagata is thinking his sister lives there. He goes running. He runs inside the temple. Didi, 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 Sita Didi. He runs and he goes there. And he sees two golden statues. Sita and Ram. He's very disappointed. He asks the Pujari, Panditji, where is my sister? I heard my sister lives in this mahal. What is your sister's name? Sita. And what is her husband's name? Shri Ram. Yeah, this is Sita Ram. Shri Sita Ram. No, I'm not talking about Murti. I want my sister. And he ran out of the temple crying. And he sat under a tree outside the temple and started crying. This tree is still there in Ayodhya. He's crying, sitting under the tree. Didi, Didi, Sita, Didi, where are you? This cannot happen. My mother could not have lied to me. These sadhus could not have lied to me. My mother said that you live here in Ayodhya. Where are you, Didi? Where are you, Didi? Started crying. Some sadhus came hearing this 8-year-old child cry so piteously. Are Baba, child, what happened? Why are you crying? No, I came here to meet my Didi. I cannot find her. What is your Didi's name? Sita. What family is she living? What is her husband's name? Shri Ram. She's in that mahal. Go. No, I went. Those are murtis. I want my Didi. They are laughing. Oh, this boy, poor boy. Oh, he doesn't know. Okay, they just walked away. Everybody either ignored him or they made fun of him or they laughed at him. But for Prayagdatta, it was not a joke. Prayagdatta had full faith in the words of his mother. And the mother had full faith that Sita is my daughter. And therefore, she is the Didi of my Prayagdatta. Prayagdatta started crying. He remembered the mantra he had gotten from his mother. Sita Ram Jai Sita Ram. Sita Ram Jai Sita Ram. And then he got angry at Ram. I don't know where Shri Ram has taken my sister. I cannot find. This is the city of my brother-in-law. I am the Sala. I have come here to meet my sister. I don't know where my Jijaji has put my sister. So he got angry at Ram and he stopped chanting Ram Nam. Sita, 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 Didi, Sita, Didi, Sita, 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 Sita. How we chant Radhanam? Ratte raho Radhanam. Like that, he started chanting Sita, 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 started crying. Tears were coming from his eyes. Sita, Sita, Sita. Now, whenever devotees cry, chanting the holy names, Hanumanji is always there. Hanumanji is always there. Hanumanji could not tolerate this little child cry so piteously. And he went and he requested Sita and Ram that this is your own home and your own dear devotee has come. He's an innocent 8-year-old boy. You had given darshan to the 5-year-old Dhruv. You had appeared for the 5-year-old Prahlad. Now this boy is crying. Please give him darshan. And Sita and Ram, they can never avoid the request of such a devotee as Hanumanji. They immediately went. And here Prayagdath is crying, 8-year-old child, Sita, Sita Didi, where are you? And suddenly he hears a booming, thunderous declaration. Tribhuvananath, Chakravarti Samrat, Ayodhyapati, Shri Ram, Janak Nandani, Shri Sita Devi, Padhar Rahe Hai. They are arriving. Sita and Ram are arriving. This 8-year-old boy Prayagdath is looking along the road. Where is my sister? Where is my sister? Where is Sita Devi? And he sees a huge, beautiful, royal white elephant. On the back of the elephant is a throne. And on the throne, a very, very beautiful personality is sitting. His complexion is Ghanashyam, like a rain-filled cloud. His eyes are very, very beautiful, like the petals of a lotus. He has very beautiful, soft, curly black hair. He is wearing a very beautiful royal mukut on his head, crown. Very beautiful Kaustub Mani adorns his chest. His arms are very beautiful and slender and long. And he is wearing a Pitambar Vastra and is sitting. And on his left lap, someone who is even more beautiful than Shri Ram is sitting. And that is Srimati Sita Devi. She is so attractive that when for the first time Shri Ram saw Sita Devi in the garden of Janak Maharaj, Lord Ramachandra's brow broke out in a sweat. When Ram had seen the beauty of Sita Devi, Lord Ram was overwhelmed. This is the beauty of Sita Devi. Just like Radharani overwhelms Shri Krishna. Similarly, Srimati Sita Devi is so beautiful that she attracts Shri Ram. Just like Srimati Radharani, our Radharani, she is Madan Mohan Mohini. Our Sita Devi also, who is a part of Srimati Radharani. She's an amsh of Srimati Radharani. She's an incarnation of Srimati Radharani. She also attracts her consort, Shri Ram. And this white elephant was very beautiful and royal and surrounded by amazing, amazing servants who were playing musical instruments, who were chanting beautiful verses glorifying Sita and Ram. They came and they stopped in front of Prayagdatta. And Prayagdatta is not even looking at Ram. He's only looking at Sita Devi, his sister. And the elephant comes and sits down. And few servants, they bring a golden ladder and they keep. And first, Shri Ram gets down from the white elephant. And then Shri Ram gives his hand to Sita Devi. And then slowly, Sita Devi gets down from the elephant's back. And as soon as Sita Devi gets down, she leaves the hand of Shri Ram and she comes running towards Prayagdatta. She says, my dear brother, where were you? I was waiting for you. Where were you? And Srimati Sita Devi gives a loving embrace to Prayagdatta. And Prayagdatta is embracing his Didi. No one was telling me where you were. I was searching for you. I was crying for so long. I came all the way from Janakpur just to see you, sister. Don't cry. With her own sari, Sita Devi wiped all the tears of Prayagdatta 200 years ago, my dear friends. This is a true story. She wiped the tears of Prayagdatta, who was crying. She said, don't cry. Some servants went and brought a royal chair for Prayagdatta. She said, sit down, my dear brother. And Prayagdatta sat down. Some servants bought an aarti tray for Sita Devi. And Sita Devi took the aarti tray and she offered aarti to Prayagdatta. My dear brother, she put tilak for Prayagdatta. And then she took a very beautiful rakhi And she tied with her own loving hands the Rakhi on the right hand of Prayag Datta. And then she, from the plate, she took laddus. And with her own loving hands, she fed Prayag Datta. Prayag Datta, each and every hair on his body was erupting, standing in ecstasy. He had never experienced anything like this. The whole atmosphere was surcharged with the fragrance of Sita Devi, with the love of Sita Devi. Prayag Datta's entire complexion became golden effulgent by the touch of Sita, by the embrace of Sita Devi. And then Prayag Datta remembered. He said, Didi, I have not come empty-handed. Our mother has sent a gift for you. Look. And from the fold of his dhoti, Prayag Datta, 8-year-old boy, pulls out a little bundle of cloth. He opens it and there is some poha inside, dry poha. Srimati Sita Devi is so happy. She says, my dear brother, I was thinking that mother must have sent something, some gift for me. I have not received a gift from my home place, from my hometown Janakpur in ages. Thank you for bringing this gift. Thank you. She takes that chipped rice. And Sita Devi looks towards Sri Ram, who is smiling. And with her own loving hands, first Sita Devi feeds Sri Ram. And she tells Prayag Datta that, my dear brother, I never eat anything without first feeding Sri Ram. And she takes that poha and feeds Sri Ram. And Sri Ram is so happy to accept that poha. It is so tasty. So tasty. The grains of your hometown, Sita Devi, are so amazing. They beat anything that I eat in Ayodhya. This poha is better than anything that the royal cooks cook for us in the palace in Ayodhya. Very nice, very nice. After feeding Sri Ram, Srimati Sita Devi herself ate some. And then her Mahaprasad, she gave Prayag Datta. The Mahaprasad of Sri Ram and her, she gave Prayag Datta. And then the remaining remnants, she distributed to her servants. Then again, Sita Devi embraced her brother, Prayag Datta. And she told him, that my dear brother, I'm so happy you came. But you see, I am the queen. I am the wife of Sri Ram. And Sri Ram is the king of this place. He's the king of Ayodhya. He has so many duties and responsibilities. And therefore, I cannot stay here all the time. I have to go with him. He doesn't go anywhere without me. So I will go now. I want you to come back in Ayodhya. And I want you to stay with me in Ayodhya. But first, I want you to go back to Janakpur and tell our mother that you came, you met me, I tied Rakhi. Show her this Rakhi that I tied for you. And wait, I am going to send some return gifts for mother. You take them to Janakpur from Ayodhya and give them to mother. And after giving them to mother, when mother is satisfied that you are taken care of in Ayodhya, then you come back to Ayodhya and you stay with me forever, okay? And Prayag Datta was very excited. He said, yes, I will go today only. I will go to Janakpur. I will give your gifts to mother. I will show her this Rakhi. And then I will come back, Didi, and I will stay with you forever. Don't ever leave me. And mother said, I will never leave you. Prayag Datta went running to Janakpur. And seeing his effulgence as he was coming, mother understood that he has attained. He has attained the goal of life. Bhagwat Prapt. My son is Bhagwat Prapt. He has attained Radha and Krishna. He has attained Sita and Ram. She knew just by seeing his brilliant effulgence. And he came and he told the whole story. How he cried. How he had darshan. How Ram and Sita ate the poha. The chipped rice that was sent. He showed the Rakhi. And he gave the gifts that Sita Devi had sent. For the mother. And then he took permission and said that, mother, now give me permission to go back to Ayodhya. Didi is calling me. Didi wants me to be with her. And mother said, yes. Mother understood that my son, his life is perfect. She said, go, beta, go. You go to Ayodhya. Be with your sister. So he came back to Ayodhya. And the place where he did bhajan, that place is still there. And you know what he's called in Ayodhya, even today? Mamaji. He is famous by the name Mamaji. You know why? Because in Ayodhya, the bhav is that she is Sita Maiya. She is Mother Sita. And he is the brother of Mother Sita. So he is Mamaji. So that place of the bhajan of Mamaji is still there in Ayodhya. So my dear friends, Ayodhya, Janakpur, these places, Vrindavan Dham, they are filled with such Mahabhagavata Vaishnavas who through the ages have performed such bhajan and completely controlled the heart of our Nitai. And therefore Nitai is coming and he's crying. Remembering all these things, seeing all these things in Ayodhya, Nitai is remembering, Tabe gela Nityananda Ayodhya Nagare. Tabe gela Nityananda Ayodhya Nagara Rama Janma Bhumi Dekhi Kandila Vistara. This is the reason why he's crying. Nitai is crying. So these are some thoughts I wanted to share with all of you, dear devotees. We will continue with Nityananda Prabhu's pilgrimage. And next Sunday, our Nitai is going to meet Shripad Madhavendra Puri. So please sit tight and we'll continue our reading of Sri Chaitanya Bhagavat If Krishna Desires next Sunday. Sri Chaitanya Bhagavat Ki Jai, Sri La Vrindavan Das Thakur Mahashay Ki Jai, Sri La Prabhupada Ki Jai, Nitai Gaur Premanandi, Hari Hari Bol. Thank you very much, dear devotees. If anyone has any questions, you may unmute. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. If there are no questions, then we can.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu, Dhanvat Pranam. Dhanvat Pranam, Koti Koti Pranam, Prabhu. It's very nice pastime, Prabhu, you have described. And that Prayag, that this is the very first time I heard. Prabhu, is very nice. In Chaitanya Bhagavat, which chapter we are reading? 11th?
Prabhuji, we are in the second volume of Adi Khanda and chapter 9.
Chapter 9.
Sorry, I should have mentioned that.
And Adikhan chapter 9 and verse number was like 111 or something.
What, Prabhuji? Verse number? 122. We did till 122. Next time we will start with 123.
Okay, Prabhuji. Thank you, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Prabhu. Hare Krishna.
Thank you very much, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna. Thank you.
Thank you for class, Prabhuji.
Wonderful class, Prabhuji.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thank you. We'll stop here.
Thank you very much, Prabhuji. Dandavat Pranam. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Shyamchandra Prabhuji. Dandavat Pranam. Hare Krishna. So happy to see you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Jai Radhe Shyam. Hare Krishna.
Jai Radhe Shyam. Radhe Shyam.